Hello everyone, today we want to teach you how to use UI buttons and do different things with that. Let's stay with us.
Let's go. Yo, I'm like an addict, do I gotta have it?
Create a new button. Before doing anything on the button, click on canvas, select the screen space camera from renderer mode section, then give main camera to render camera. Select scale with screen size from UI scale mode section, then fill the fields with camera size from game window. By doing this, if the screen size is changed to any other size, the button size will not change. Click on the button and from these sections, change its size, and from this section, choose a sprite for it. There is a text in the button's child that has options for changing size, changing font, etc. Now, I want the text to change when the button is clicked. For this, create a new UI text and change the settings as you want. I already prepared a button and a text, so I will delete these two and replace those two. Look at this new button. When I pass over the button or click on it, its form changes and a special animation is played. If you wanna learn how to do this for buttons, click on the above link. Let's continue. We want on clicking the button, a comment executes. We have several ways to do this. First, after clicking button, we open button component and click on plus button as you see. We can put anything in this field by dragging towards that. For example, I drag this text to it, and from this section, I select the function to be executed, e.g. you can change layer, tag, set active condition, etc. I want to false the set active in this time. You see the box remains unchecked, so that when I click on the button, set active of the text became false. If set active of the text is false by default, by check this box, if I click on the button, text activates. Now if you play, you can see that after click, this text becomes deactive. For better understanding, I change the text after clicking button. Let's see how it works. Choose text from this section and select a string text, then write the text you want. After play and clicking on the button, you will see the text changed to bot games. In addition to clicking the button, sometimes we want to do other things with the button. For example, something else happens when we release the mouse button or when we hold the button down. For this, onClick part is no more needed and can be removed. Sometimes you want something happens to this button several times. For this, click on this plus and increase the button function. Then click on add component and select event trigger. Now if you click on add new event, you will see several options. For example, the pointer enter is for when the mouse enters the button, or pointer exit is for when the mouse exits from the button, or pointer down is for when you click on the button, and pointer up is for when you release the mouse button after click. In this time, we need three of these options: pointer down, pointer up, and update selected. Update selected is for when we hold the button down. Add pointer down, click on plus and create a new script and name it as you want. Now I drag the script to button or any other object, then I can give the script to event trigger or unclick both. If you click on no function in but script section, any public void you have created in the script will appear here. For this, open the script and write a new void. In order to be able to apply new change to this UI button, we should use UnityEngine.UI. Make a public text and give the text game object to it ahead. In the down void, put the above text equal to a string like this. Drag the text game object to that public text which was defined earlier. Then click on no function and choose your script, then select your void. After playing, you will see that when you click the button, new text changes to down. Now I want after I release the button, something happens. For this, click on add new event and select pointer up, then do what you did before, just create a new public void and change the text. Again, choose your script, then select your void and play. If you click on the button, the text will change to down, and if you release the button, the text changes to up. You can put any other command instead of this text, like shooting bullets or playing animation and other things. Now I want something to happen when I hold the button. For this, click on add new event again and select update selected. Then create a new public void like this. For showing what would happen in this void, I define a float. After that, I increase that float based on seconds. If you don't know how to work with time.time, watch the video above. For new float to be displayed, equal that predefined text to float.toString. Again, choose the new public void, which is update cell, from update selected functions. When you play, if you hold down the button, the down text will be displayed first, and immediately after that, the float number will be displayed. But when you release the button, float increasing would not be stopped. For this, open the script and define a new public integer like this. In down void, equal that integer which named as manager to 0. After that, in update cell void, write if manager equal to 0, then the following events should be happened. And in up void, which is for when I release the button, set the manager equal to 1. In this way, every time you click until you release the button, those commands will be executed. As soon as you release the button, no command will be executed anymore. If you are new to coding, it's better to go back and watch this part again. Now, it's time for the final test. After click, a number starts to increasing, and when I release the button, it converts to up. You can put any commands instead of this. For example, when you hold the button, a character moves left or right, etc. We hope... We hope this video was useful for you. Thank you. Next tutorial, it's about animating buttons with very very simple method. Don't forget subscribe us and thanks for watching our video. Picking up all the pieces is a form of art. I'm never gonna look back, cause damn, I was built to last. You move slow and I move fast.